Hi, I'm Wayne Allyn-Root for Fox News. We know Obama's bad. We know he's destroying the economy with bad policies. But the real question is, why is the GOP helping him? They can't be this incompetent, can they? Not by mistake. I think I have the answer. The GOP establishment suffers from the Stockholm syndrome. Let's start with the problem. Obama. The president and his socialist cabal are destroying America step by step, minute by minute. He's killing jobs, strangling the economy, snuffing out capitalism, and destroying our children's future lives with massive debt. He's demonizing business owners, punishing success, and redistributing income from the makers, the job creators, to the takers, his voters. And now millions of Americans are losing their health insurance because of Obamacare. Oh, and there's that little thing. He happened to know this was going to happen for 3 years now, since 2010, but said nothing. Isn't that called fraud and misrepresentation? A private sector CEO would go to prison for selling a billion-dollar product based on a big lie that no one would lose their health insurance. The real question is, why is the GOP establishment standing by as Obama destroys America? Are they stupid? Are they cowards? Are they just dense? Are they in on it, but pretending they oppose Obama, but they're really on the same team? Or are they suffering from the Stockholm syndrome? The Stockholm syndrome is a psychological phenomenon in which hostages are in a state of denial and exhibit irrational empathy, sympathy, and positive feelings towards their captors, defending and even apologizing to them. Today's GOP establishment appears to suffer from this mental disorder. Here are the real statistics of the Obama economy. They are mind-numbing, they are unimaginable, and the GOP is standing by and doing nothing. 90 million working-age Americans are not working, the highest in history. More Americans now receive entitlements than work full-time. The typical American family earns less today than in 1989. The number of Americans getting food stamps now bigger than the population of the entire Northeast United States, including New York City, Boston, and Philadelphia. It's actually bigger than the population of the country of Spain. The national debt jumped $328 billion in one day just a couple of weeks ago, more than the entire budget deficit for the year 2007 under George Bush. Nearly half of Americans have less than $500 in savings. More Americans are losing health insurance than signing up for Obamacare, by far. Yet the GOP says little, does less, and apologizes for any attempt to resist. Stockholm syndrome. Obama and his socialist cabal call conservative patriots terrorists, extortionists, legislative arsonists, and racist. And what does the GOP establishment do? They go along with Obama. They actually belittle the few courageous conservative heroes trying to save America and the US economy from a madman. Stockholm syndrome. Obama is turning America into a big brother nanny state with nasty government bureaucrats controlling our lives. He uses the IRS to destroy his critics and bankrupt his political opposition. I'm one of them, by the way. He uses the NSA to listen to our calls and communications, no doubt planning to blackmail opposition candidates. He uses the EPA to prevent America from achieving energy independence from radical Muslim nations that support terrorism. He creates new government regulations to bankrupt small business owners, thereby starving donations to conservative causes and candidates, and he uses the SEC to extort political donations from big businesses. Yet the GOP says little, does less, and apologizes at any attempt to resist. Stockholm syndrome. Then there's the corruption. Michelle Obama's Princeton College classmate just happens to be a top executive at the firm chosen to build the Obamacare website. Wow. They're both members of the Association of Black Princeton Alumni. Wow. That firm received a no-bid contract worth over $600 million and then built the worst-performing website in the history of the world. Where did the $600 million go? That's taxpayer money, not Michelle Obama's. Yet the GOP says little, does less, and apologizes at any attempt to resist. Stockholm syndrome. In the past year, Obama's fired 9 commanding generals and suspended 2 others. Is he purging the military of anyone who disagrees with his policies or has the backbone to stand up to him? Something is very wrong. These are the military leaders who keep our children safe at night. Where are the investigations? Stockholm syndrome. Obama orders the IRS to destroy critics, conservative donors, and small business owners while allowing the same IRS to hand over $4.2 billion in tax credits to illegal aliens who never pay tax in the first place and claim multiple deductions for kids who either don't exist or don't even live in this country. Yet he doesn't ask the IRS to investigate this fraud committed by real criminals. Only conservatives get hit with IRS investigations. If this was a script in a fictional movie, Hollywood wouldn't even think of buying it. It's that absurd. Yet the GOP says little, does less, and apologizes at any attempt to resist. Stockholm syndrome. America's being destroyed, ladies and gentlemen, yet the GOP fumbles, retreats, and apologizes. It's tragic. One party's filled with frauds, crooks, and Marxists out to bankrupt this economy, wreck capitalism, and destroy America. And the other party's filled with weak-willed cowards, either scared of their own shadow, in cahoots with Obama, or suffering from the Stockholm syndrome. America, wake up. Throw out all the bums in D.C. before it's too late and the greatest country in world history is gone forever. I'm Wayne Allyn Root, a small businessman, patriot, and the author of the Ultimate Obama Survival Guide for Fox News. God bless America.